Do you know how to pick out a solar inverter? If not, stick around for some of our expert tips. Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry.
And let's jump right into it, Larry. Before we do that, what is an inverter?
So the inverter is the part of the system that converts the power from DC coming off the roof to AC that you can use in your house. And it's also the brains of the inverter. Right. So with it, you can monitor the production, see the health of your solar panels, and those types of things.
Great. So how does an inverter actually work? How does it do that?
There's two parts that I'd like to think about. The first is, like I said, the DC to AC conversion. And then secondly, the MPP tracking, the maximum power point tracking. So the inverter's job is at all points of the day, whether it's shady, sunny, windy, as the temperature changes, as the sun goes down, constantly pulling the maximum power out of each point or out of each module that it can.
Are there different types of inverters?
So there are three different types of inverters that we use, the string inverter, the microinverter, and then the string plus power optimizer. And we do have another video that goes into detail on this, on those three options. But I'll just briefly talk about each of the three, kind of how they work, some pros and cons, where they should be used, that type of thing. So the string inverter, that's the cheapest option. We typically use that on ground mounts. It's quote unquote the dumbest inverter. It doesn't have module level power electronics. You just install it and it works. The benefit is it's the cheapest. The negative is you can't pull the maximum power out of each module like you could with some of the other options. And you also can't monitor on a module level, but it's perfect for ground mounts and areas of low shade. The next option is microinverters, and really microinverters and string plus power optimizer are very similar in their pros and cons, how they work and where they should be used. So I'll kind of tie them together. They should be used on rooftops where you need rapid shutdown. Rapid shutdown is simply shutting off the module when the system goes down. So if for any reason you need to kill the power at the module level, you can do that from the ground level. It also does shade mitigation. It pulls the power out of each module. So if one module is shaded, it doesn't affect the module beside it. You can also monitor each module individually. But then there's a catch. It's the most expensive.
Sure.
The main difference between microinverters and power optimizers, they do basically the same thing. Typically, the microinverter has a longer warranty, and then the power optimizer is more cost-effective. So that's kind of the trade-off there.
And we'll link to those other videos on inverters in the description below as well, if you'd like to watch those. So Larry, what are some of the factors that somebody should think about when they're picking out an inverter?
Probably the main one is, what's your service voltage? You know, are you single-phase 240, three-phase 208, three-phase 480? That's going to help you narrow it down pretty quickly as to what line of inverter you can choose from. What are the costs that you're willing to bear? Do you want the higher cost, more benefit, more warranty? Do you want lower cost? What's your shading like? What's your space like? Are you trying to get maximum power out of every square foot, or are you willing to have a little bit lower cost, maybe not quite as much benefit out of each square foot? What kind of maintenance are you looking for long term? You know, your microinverters are going to be up on the roof. Would you rather have it down at ground level where you can maintain it a bit better? What are the code requirements? Rapid shutdown. We talked about that briefly. What kind of warranties are you looking for? What about compatibility with other equipment? EV chargers, batteries. A lot of inverter manufacturers today, and I'm thinking of SolarEdge and Enphase particularly, are looking for ways to also do EV charging, integrate batteries. So if that's something that's important to you, you'll want to consider that. What kind of monitoring are you looking for? You're looking for module level. You want to know what each solar panel is doing. Or are you okay with the inverter level or even system level monitoring? And then sizing and selecting inverters for your system. This is something that we do with every design. We think about oversizing. We think about clipping. And we have another video that goes into all kinds of detail on clipping. And we'll also link that in the description below so you can do more digging around with that.
And then once you get all this information figured out and you know more or less all of these details and what you're looking for, what's the process or the steps to figure out which solar inverter to use based on all this information?
So first of all, determine the system size and power requirements.
Yeah.
How much production do you want? What kind of space do you have? And so as a result, how many modules are you going to use, and what size system are you going to have? And then decide on the type of solar inverter. You know, do you want the string inverter? power optimizer, the microinverter, research different brands and models. Again, that's something that we do in-house. We spend a lot of time researching brands, models, trying to figure out what makes the most sense for our customers. Check the technical specifications and features. What about inverter efficiency? You know, how do the modules work with the inverter? And then consider your compatibility with, like we said, EV chargers and batteries. And then compare warranties and prices. And you know, you put all that together, you figure out which inverter to get. Seems like a lot of information. And again, that's something we do in-house when we understand what our customers are looking for.
So now that we've given you the tips to pick out a solar inverter, the next step in the process is to watch our top solar inverter video to figure out which brands make the most sense for you. Thanks for watching. We hope you found this valuable.